Hello everyone, welcome to a new exciting adventure with Doc Savage Explorations. This is going to be a very special episode because we are about to begin the exploration for two of the most famous and also the most elusive legends in all of the Southwest. I'm standing here at El Morro, at the top of El Morro, and let's see, 30 miles to the west is the Zuni Pueblo. Around to the east, 20 miles, is the El Malpais National Monument. Now both of these locations are going to figure into the legends as we explore them. So what legends are we talking about? They're famous. The first legend is the Lost Seven Cities of Cibola. I'm sure most people are familiar with that. The second legend is the Lost Adams gold diggings. A lot of people are familiar with that, especially treasure hunters. But those are the two legends we're going to be exploring. And so now let's take a look at the history, how they began, and then we'll start the exploration. After the Spanish had conquered the indigenous tribes of Mexico and looted all of the gold they could find, they began to hear tales of fabulous golden cities to the north. In the 1530s, conquistador Cabeza de Vaca ventured north and returned to Mexico with tales of seven golden cities. In February 1540, Francisco Vázquez de Carnaro departed Mexico with a large expedition determined to find these golden cities and claim them for Spain. In June of 1540, Coronado reached the Zuni Pueblo. He immediately read the standard proclamation demanding the Zuni surrender and essentially become slaves of their empire. The Zuni warriors responded with a volley of arrows, but they were soon defeated by the well-equipped conquistadors. The Zunis fled, and the Spaniards ransacked the Pueblo but found no gold. Coronado began exploring the area to the west and discovered the Grand Canyon. He also went east all the way to the Rio Bravo, present-day Albuquerque, and explored the Pueblos there. But he never found Cibola or any gold to speak of. Coronado returned to Mexico in 1542, a miserable failure.
A thousand years ago in the Southwest, there was an Apache legend. It told about a hidden canyon guarded by the Apache gods and rich with gold. As long as the Apaches kept the canyon a secret and never touched the gold, they would be strong, powerful. That was the legend. When the Spanish conquistadores came, they searched for that canyon. They called it Canyon del Oro, meaning Canyon of Gold, but they never found it. 300 years later, the Americans came. They heard about the legend, but they called the canyon the Lost Adams. That was because a man named Adams saw it once, or so he said. But whether he did or not, he never saw anything again because the Apaches burned out his eyes. Everybody knew about that legend, and a lot of people believed it. Canyon del Oro, the Lost Adam. And then, for a while there, back in 1874, they called it McKenna's Gold.
Old turkey buzzard, old turkey buzzard, flying, flying high.
He's just a wee.
Adams, born in 1829, moved from New York to Los Angeles in 1861 at the age of 32 and started a freight company hauling goods between Tucson and Los Angeles. In the summer of 1864, Adams lost his wagons to Apaches near Sacaton, Arizona, south of present-day Phoenix. Adams ended up in a cantina nearby filled with prospectors, telling his hard luck story to everyone. There was a Mexican Apache man there called Gotcher, telling everyone he knew where there was a canyon filled with gold. Gotcher was on the run and agreed to lead the prospectors to the canyon for two horses and a gun. So the expedition of 22 men set out from Sacaton on August 20, 1864. On August 25th, they camped in a saddle between two peaks thought to be Mount Ord and Mount Baldy near Springerville, Arizona. Gotcher pointed out two peaks 100 miles away to the northeast, saying the goal was near them. On August 30th, they came across a wagon trail which Gotcher told them led to a fort in the Malpais Rocks. On August 31st, they rode through a narrow canyon and into a lava rock field. The twin peaks marking the Gold Canyon was just ahead of them. They entered a zigzag canyon and emerged into a small little valley with running water and a small waterfall at the upper end of the Box Canyon. The prospectors saw color in the small stream and began panning for gold, which they found in abundance. The next day, the Apache chief Nana and 30 warriors appeared in the canyon. He told the miners they could take gold from the stream, but never to go above the waterfall. He told Adams the canyon was called Snow Tahe. The miners built a small cabin and buried their gold under the fireplace for safety. One day, a miner went above the waterfall and found an egg-sized gold nugget. A few days later, the Apaches attacked the camp and burned the cabin, killing most of the miners. Adams and a few other men escaped by hiding and traveling at night. Reportedly, there was about 300 pounds of gold left behind under the fireplace of the burned-out cabin. Today's prices, this gold would be worth $8.75 million. Okay, welcome back. You should have a good background of each of the legends now. Let's look at the legend of the Seven Cities of Cibola. As many of you probably know, people have been searching for this since, the 1500s. Coronado was one of the famous explorers who came north to look for it. That was about 500 years ago. So people have been looking for it for a long time with zero success. This leads me to believe that if these cities exist, they're going to be in underground caverns. And New Mexico, northern New Mexico, is full of these underground caverns. So it is a possibility. So I'm going to use that to formulate the first anchor point. Anchor point one will be the entrance to the lost golden city of Cibola. Now let's look at the second legend, which is the Lost Adams. The Lost Adams, as you may know from the history, was found in a canyon somewhere in western New Mexico. That canyon is full of gold, and there's even larger nuggets on the mesa adjacent to it. So the formulation for the second anchor point is going to be the Lost Adams gold diggings. So with that in mind, let's go ahead and set our first base point, and then we'll get started. Okay, I am here at the first base point. It's labeled NM Base 1. The coordinates should be on your screen. And I'm happy to report I did the remote anchoring and I got good data on each of our targets. So we have good data to start with. And okay, here are the direction vectors. I'll put them on your screen. Anchor point one, of course, is the lost golden city of Cibola, and anchor point two is the lost Adams. So here are the first direction vectors. I'm going to put the plots on Google Earth on your screen so you get some idea where they're going. I know the direction vector for Cibola is going about north. And the one for Lost Adams It was going, let's see, it was going about southwest, I think. So let me plot that on Google Earth and you'll see a much better image of those. We'll continue on with the next episode. It's early winter. Winter is starting, so I plan on localizing these two targets during the winter and, get on site maybe first of spring and get started with the on-ground exploration. Don't exactly know what we're going to run into. This kind of thing, you never really know what you're going to run into, especially with a Cibola. We kind of know what, atoms, the lost atoms, we kind of know what we're looking for. But Cibola could be anywhere. It could, it'd be behind a rock somewhere. So I hope you enjoyed this episode. See you next time.